Hi, welcome everybody to the third week of Junesploitation, and we are talking about the Blaxploitation classic directed by Gordon Parks Jr., Superfly from 1972, starring Ron O'Neill. And I'm going to talk to my man Rob.
I'm dancing because I can already hear the music.
A historically famous soundtrack by yes. Curtis Mayfield. And I'm not saying this as any kind of knock against the movie, but like the soundtrack is the best thing about.
Oh, easily. Oh, let's just start off just off the bat. Yes, the soundtrack is the best part of this movie.
I love that Curtis Mayfield has a scene unto himself to perform one of the songs in a club. I will say this though. This has I love in Blaxploitation movies when they have the lounge scene. Nice. It's my favorite part of any Blaxploitation movie is when we get like, let's take 10 minutes to set a scene in a lounge and you're going to hear like one or two songs uninterrupted. And then it's something you have to Shazam because it's amazing. And like, and then it just usually ends up in a fight or just some kind of bravado or like some sassy ladies. And stuff.
Everyone's
going to
be dressed immaculately. The clothes yes. are going to be amazing.
Yeah. But yeah. I bring this up because I felt bad for Curtis Mayfield because he's like playing in the world's tiniest Sunday of a club. But, I mean, I've heard of budget limitations, but this club is too small. They go to the back into the kitchen to have a meeting. Yes. And I was at like waiting with bated breath. I'm like, how small is this kitchen going to be? And it's small too.
That being said.
Yeah.
This movie, this is my first time seeing it. I think it was your first time seeing it too, right?
Yeah, I've seen the remake, which I like, but this was my first time seeing the original.
It was about what I expected. I can't say it's my favorite of the genre. I'm definitely a fan of some of the other ones. You know, Sweetback is a great movie. I'm such a huge fan of Coffee as well. There are other movies in this genre that I feel like are maybe a little bit stronger. But the thing I was taken the most by with this is just the incredible filmmaking, just the incredible like stylistic of its time, very much that sort of 70s New Hollywood sort of approach where it's a little bit down and dirty. It's a documentary style for a lot of it. The pacing is, you know, the film breathes, scenes are allowed to breathe. The acting is kind of, you know, the polite way to say it is homemade. You know, it's got that very sort of, it's got that sort of authenticity to it that really makes you feel like it's all part of a piece. And some of the filmmaking techniques, like, you know, the sort of split screens, kind of still images, and a lot of the other sort of period appropriate filmmaking techniques are just, you can see it's weird. It's always weird to see. It's like, you know, you go back and watch like Lawrence of Arabia and you're for the first time and you're like, oh, well, this is where the next 60 years of cinema came from. Like, now I understand where this technique and that character archetype and all those things came from. For me, watching Superfly was very similar to that, where even though I'm already familiar with movies of the era and of Blaxploitation in general, I can watch this movie and go like, oh, now I see where like so many other pieces of the rest of that puzzle were really born. So it was a really, for me, really informative and important kind of viewing, even though really at no point in the movie did I really know what was going on or really care, or was I really able to track most of these characters. It's a vibes movie. It really doesn't matter. So, you know, again, not my favorite of the bunch, but definitely a really, really interesting and important experience.
Yeah, for me, I'm no expert really on Blaxploitation cinema, but I always gravitate more to the horror genre version of Blaxploitation cinema. So I like the crime stuff. I like, you know, Truck Turner and Shaft well enough and everything like that. And Superfly kind of fits into that bunch for me in the sense that I wish I was there when it came out. I wish I was there like to experience it within that culture, like at the time, because you can just imagine like how well this plays with an audience, and like watching it at home with on Amazon is a little bit different. But I mean, like you said, there's so much to appreciate. Like I don't recall seeing Ron O'Neill, who plays Superfly, in any other movie, but like just he's got like a presence, and maybe I'm thinking of because of his facial hair kind of coming to like blades
Points on
towards
side.
his mouth. He's got like a Wolverine thing going on where he's just like such presence, like
Yes.
automatically you like can't take your eyes off of him. And I love that his friend, his partner in crime literally is like Proto Eddie Griffin.
Yeah, I mean, kind of.
Yeah, he just reminds me so much of like a 10-year older Eddie Griffin that you got used to seeing in the early 2000s. And I like that their kind of interpersonal conflict is more based off of like, yeah, all right, I'll help you. Like I'll help you like get this one big score so you can retire. But it's all based off of like, what's in it for me? Like, what's the best thing for me? So his partner is just sort of like on board until he's just like, man, you're leaving so much money on the table. Like, and it's not even like, well, now we're at odds. It's just kind of like, why are you doing this? I just really appreciate that it wasn't, and I can't remember the remake of Superfly too well, but what I remember from that movie is basically just like, you know, we're at odds. My whole crew is against your whole crew. And this is one where it's just like, we could probably resolve this with a conversation. But yeah, like you said, I mean, the vibes are immaculate. It's really fun. If you're looking for something to watch on Blaxploitation Day, this hits the nail on the head. I mean, it's perfect viewing for it.
And it's not, I was reading a little bit about, some of the controversies surrounding the film and its relationship with sort of a black hero, specifically a black drug dealer hero, and whether or not, in a lot of the literature that's come out since, with that the film is sort of blamed for some stereotyping. And I wasn't necessarily, it's hard to look outside of the movie as a movie and look at it as a piece of literature or as a sort of socio-political commentary and without feeling hypocritical, obviously, because I do not share this experience. This is not my experience, so I don't have that sort of personal investment in it. When I look at the movie, though, as a sort of artifact of film history, that's where I really am sort of feeling the most positive about it. So I understand, I was reading a few things about kind of, well, the movie portrays people in a certain way, a certain kind of person doing a certain kind of thing, and that's not necessarily, a sort of a progressive enough viewpoint. But I think the characters feel genuine, the characters feel true to who they are or they are portrayed as in the film. And so looking at the movie as a historical artifact, I can just judge its quality kind of based on that. But
I'll just speak for myself. It's impossible for me as like a white person viewing this 50 years later to really pass judgment on what is right and what is wrong
so,
on like in terms of the representation. Like at best, my reaction should be, did I enjoy the movie? And that's it. And then I should probably shut up about
yeah,
like
exactly.
anything more than that. So on those terms, I had a good time with it. It was not my favorite Blaxploitation movie, but I've seen a lot of other Blaxploitation movies I didn't like as much as Superfly. So, all right. So we are winding down Junesploitation, and we are going to be back next week with a review of Black Sunday, a movie that I've seen the opening scene of in clip shows over and over and over again. And now, finally, we have the opportunity to watch the whole thing. So I'm excited.
Adam, if you
Yes.
not have a leather jacket or a great hat, nor a personal theme that evokes both coolness, authority, danger, sexiness, or
I disagree
just
with some of these, but I think that you're cool and badass, and I love you, buddy.
proud of you too. Until next time.
You didn't see that coming at the end of the Blaxploitation episode, did you? Anyways, until next time, these seats are in a tiny club where Curtis Mayfield on stage.